Basically, if you sell it with your warning on it, not for human consumption, that kind of just writes you off for any responsibility.
Hmm?
That's it. You put the note on there.
Yep.
And that's you done.
Yep.
Has the same sort of deterioration that you'd expect from crack.
Chantel started using legal highs around 2 years ago and claims her addiction has now got so bad she is selling her body in order to fund a habit. Though they're called legal highs, they have the same impact as illegal substances.
It almost took my life.
So I got a water build up on my pelvis.
My heart started racing faster, and then I started having like this seizure thing on the floor.
So I was informed that this is the effect of spice.
And then after that, I completely blanked out, dude.
I woke up after the spice with vomit all over my bed.
This is what spice does to you.
Woke up in the hospital having no idea what had happened.
Nobody really knows what they're made up of and what structure they have. And
I know a heroin addict that's a spice addict now that takes spice like you used to take heroin. What is in this stuff?
Pretty much most of our clients are using spice. Well, I think the main reason that it's being used quite a lot is it's cheap. It's affecting the mental health, it's affecting the physical health.
How are you feeling?
I could want to kill someone.
Was the aggression built up?
I don't want it, but I'm in pain.
And I get agitated myself because my head's thinking, I need this.
They are far more dangerous and they are far more unpredictable than cannabis.
Where does it hurt?
Shooting pains down my leg. Shooting pains up my spine.
We have no understanding of what the potential dangers of those drugs might be.
It probably contains items in it which are illegal. Where we come across that, we deal with those offences, we arrest people.
And some people I've seen and it's just completely changed their lives, they're not the same people anymore.
After about 5-10 minutes after actually smoking it, she was passed out on the sofa. She ended up going to hospital because her heart was skipping beats.
The figures we've got at the moment suggest about one person a week is dying in the UK from a novel psychoactive substance. But that's probably an underestimate.